This comment was left in reply to another one that said, "Maybe you should move to the bushes of PNG where no colonialism exists." I want to address both of these comments. I am not anti-European or anti-Christian. What I am is anti-white supremacy, which both of these comments are rooted in. Using Papua New Guinea to symbolize being uncivilized, which I've been seeing a lot in my comments, is extremely problematic and rooted in anti-blackness. We need to stop using the word civilized altogether. It's a colonial term used to other, invade, and exploit. We call places that adhere to Western standards civilized and those who don't uncivilized. Our Pacific societies are deemed barbaric for not conforming to Western ideals, but the West continues to steal land and resources to this day. How is that civil? And I'm not against Christianity itself, but I am against using any belief system to justify oppressing others. Believe what you want, but don't use it as an excuse to cause harm. For too long, we've let the West dictate morality. Their morality said it was okay to murder and displace indigenous peoples and steal their land. Their morality justified enslaving black and brown bodies and forcing them into labor on a scale unlike any other time in history. Their supposed higher morality gives them license to invade other countries under the guise of saving them. And if you think that this is all in the past and we should just get over it, you're speaking from a place of privilege. You don't see how these systems are operating today because they don't affect you. Decolonization isn't about hating Europeans or Christians. It's about dismantling the white supremacist ideologies that have justified centuries of violence, theft, and oppression. It's about asserting that all cultures have inherent worth, not just those that conform to Western standards. Instead of telling me to go live in the bush, I invite you to examine the biases underlying that statement. Educate yourself on the ongoing impacts of colonialism. Listen to indigenous peoples when we share our stories. We're all learning and growing, but growth requires facing hard truths, letting go of defensiveness, and being open to perspectives beyond our own.